Hi, everyone. I'm Tim, and today I'm going to talk to you guys about my research on the eye and the brain. And so I studied the retina, which is the thin piece of tissue at the back of your eye that allows you to see the world around you. And specifically, I study how cells in the retina connect to each other over development, so from an embryo to a newly born animal all the way to adulthood. Now, one of the big unanswered questions in my field is something that I call the dating problem. So what do I mean by this? Well, imagine we're out in the real world and you have someone out who's dating, like this lady in blue here. And she has to find her right partner, who's this man in blue here. One of her challenges is that she has to find the right partner amid many, many different possibilities. And it turns out that cells in the retina often have to do the same thing. So the retina is organized into three layers of cells, just like this diagram, 1, 2, and 3. And when you look at an object, the light hits the object, goes into your eye through your pupil, past these first two layers of cells, and hits the cells at the very back of your eye, in this top layer here. And these cells are called rods and cones. You can imagine that the men in black, these are the rods, and that the lady in blue, she's a cone. Now, when light hits the cone, she becomes activated, and she's going to send her information to a cell in this middle layer here. But she can't just send her information to anybody. Who she sends her information to matters. She has to have the right partner. This is because the cells in the middle are specialized to do different things. Some of them are specialized to process colors, like red and blue. Some of them are specialized to process object shapes, while others process object movement. Now, let's suppose that the lady in blue, she specializes in processing the color blue. The nervous system has to make sure that she connects to a cell in the middle that also processes the color blue, like this man in blue here. And so how does the nervous system do this? Well, research from other labs has found that this man in blue, he releases chemicals into the environment that act as attractants, kind of like good-smelling cologne. They tell a lady in blue, hey, come towards me, come make a connection with me. And from my own research, I found that these men in black in the middle layer, they also release chemicals into the environment, but these chemicals are smelly and repulsive. They tell the lady in blue, hey, get away from me, don't make a connection with me. And the second group of smelly, repulsive chemicals, these chemicals are called semaphorins. That's the fancy scientific name. Now, when these chemicals are released into the environment, somehow the lady in blue, she has to detect them. She has to know that they're there. And how does she do this? Well, we found that she uses something called a neuropilin. That's the detector molecule. So why is this research important? Why should you care? Well, knowing how cells choose their partners will help us better understand how the nervous system processes things like colors and shapes. And these principles may also generalize to other brain regions involved in decision-making and emotion. But more importantly, knowing how cells choose their partners will be essential if we ever want to regenerate the retina after injury to help blind people see again. And so to summarize, today we talked about the importance of dating in neuroscience and talked about a couple of different ways in which cells choose their partners, one example being the semaphorin and its detector, neuropilin. Thank you.